Hi, my name is Colin Goble. What I'd like to do is show you how to use the Bloodshed C++ compiler in order to edit, compile, and execute a program written in C++. So the version of C++ that I'm using here is 4.9.9.2, the latest version at the time I do this demo. First thing that you'll want to do is launch the compiler, Bloodshed C++. The next thing you'll want to do once you've got it launched is to enter the program, the C++ source program that you've written. The first thing to do is go to the File menu, type New, because we're probably going to be creating a new source file. We're going to click on Source File. We could have gone to Project here, but our programs, at least at the beginning of this term, are going to be pretty straightforward. We'll just use a source file, so we'll go to New, Source File. And a source file editing window opens over here on the right-hand side of the screen. Right now it's entitled Untitled 1. Now at this point you're going to write your C++ program. In the case of this first exercise, Hello World, it's already been written for you. And so what I've done is take helloworld.cpp, which you can download from WebCT. I've copied it into the Windows clipboard. And now what I'm going to do is edit and paste it. I could have shortcutted with Control V, but I'm going to paste it off the Edit menu into the window, the Untitled 1 window on the right-hand side of the screen. So there we have it. I did the paste. The program from WebCT is now in our Edit window. And what we need to do now is take a quick look at the various components of a C++ source program. The first section here is a whole set of comments, and what you need to do in that comment section is specify what the program does and a description of what it does, your name as the author of the program, the date that you wrote it, any sources of outside help you may have received that you need to attribute or credit with them having received any help, and then that's essentially the end of what I call the standard boilerplate. Now after that, because this is a C++ program written in the ANSI 1998 standard, we need to include IOStream. Any program you write this term will need to include the IOStream input-output library. By the way, if you've used an earlier version of C or C++, don't use IOStream.h here. This 1998 standard is just IOStream. We want to use the so-called STD namespace, also part of the ANSI 1998 standard. So those two lines are going to be standard boilerplate in anything you write. And here is the body of our program. This is the program that's going to display. When we run the program, it's going to say, Hello World. This is the program that you're going to now compile and execute. So having written our program and got it the way we want, the next thing to do is probably to save it. It hasn't been saved yet, so we'll go to File, we'll go to Save As, and in my case, I've got on my hard drive, I've created a folder called CS161. In that folder, I'm going to put all of the programs I'm going to work on this term, and I've created a subfolder called Hello World. So this first program is called Hello World. I'll create its a little folder to put it in, and I've been working with this program before, so actually I've already got helloworld.cpp there, but what you're going to need to do is in the file name type helloworld.cpp, and all C++ source files are going to have an extension of cpp. So we're going to save our program. I'm going to overwrite the file I had from before, and our program is now saved to hard disk. The next thing we want to do is convert the program from the C++ source code that we've written into the machine language that's going to execute on the microprocessor inside our PC, and that process is known as compiling. So I'm going to go to Execute Compile. I'm going to compile the program. Event quickly, actually, its status says done. It's finished the compiling process. In this case, we had no errors and no warnings. So I'm going to close the Compile Progress dialog box. And now, of course, the moment of truth. We want to execute the program and see if it does what we hoped it would do. So I'm going to go back to the Execute menu. We're going to run the program. And a little DOS box opens up. Our program outputs Hello World, and then asks us to press Q followed by Enter to close the DOS dialog box and thus quit the program. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to press Q for quit. I'm going to Enter to enter that line into the program. Our program's tested out correctly, and actually what we've done is finished this. We've got to the end of this lesson. We've written our program, compiled it, executed it, and everything has worked okay. Thank you very much for joining us.